Okay, so that was my boarding call. I'm getting ready to board my flight to Orlando to go to the Warped Tour. I'm so excited. I'll probably be checking in on Friday. I'm going to try to upload some videos from the Warped Tour, but you know how that goes. Who knows if that'll actually be able to happen. But until then, check out this amazing video that Debbie sent in. She's hilarious. I love her. And I think you will too. And if you're interested in having one of your videos featured on Threadbanger, email me at threadbangerstyle@gmail.com, and I'll see you later. Kind of looks like I'm flicking you off, but I'm not. I'm doing the scissors, I swear. Love you guys.
Hey Threadbangers, today we're gonna doll up some shoes. I'm gonna try and do this the whole time I'm teaching you how to do it. That's not right. How? This way. Thread bangers. Thread. I'm gonna show you how to make shoe embellishments. We're gonna use these tiny magnets for our shoes, and I like them because they're inconspicuous. To flip-flops, you can do this to ballet flats, you can do this to any kind of shoes you want to wear.
Start with your favorite craft supplies and heavy gauge sandpaper to create a good surface for the glue to stick to if you're using rubber flip-flops. You can also cut out a tiny piece of felt with a hole punch. This will do the same thing. Gluing the magnets on looks pretty simple, but it actually can be a little bit tricky.
When you decide to put the glue on your shoe, you have to make sure that you're gluing the right side down, because one side the magnets like each other and the other side they don't.
E6000 is my favorite glue to use when working with rhinestone chain or jewelry supplies. You can find it at Michael's Craft Store or Walmart. Step to the beat, I woke up today, canceled all my plans, and I stepped right outside with my guitar. The tiny magnets that I use are so powerful that you are supposed to slide them from side to side rather than pulling them, because you could actually chip the magnets. Use wire cutters to snip off the clips of vintage earrings and add millinery flowers. Here I use vintage bottle caps, googly eyes, and false eyelashes. These are going to be great for Halloween, which is just around the corner.
Who wouldn't want doll heads on their toes? Because they're always doing this. It's hard to do it when you're not looking directly at the shoe, but it goes off and it goes on. Off, on.
These are yo-yos taken from a vintage quilt and another pair of earrings. I created my initials by adding rhinestones to vintage menu board letters that I bought off of Etsy.
So if you like my video, subscribe to my channel. I make lots of YouTube videos. And you might see more of the puppy coming up soon, because he likes to make stuff with me.
Let me know in a comment below what you would put on your shoes. And check out more of my DIY videos at debbiesdesigndiary.com and on my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Oh, yeah.